Rohit Kumar Rudrappa Wagdarikar, working as an assistant professor in computer science and engineering department at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss about the gate block scenarios of 4 and 5 in Unix operating system. As we have already seen, the scenarios of 1st, 2nd and 3rd in our previous videos. So now today we'll start for the 4 and 5. Now in the learning objectives outcomes, at the end of this lecture or session, the students will understand the concepts of gate block scenario 4 and 5 and its gate block algorithm also. So now today here I'll give the just simple review actually what these gate block scenarios are. The algorithm for reading and writing this block uses the algorithm gate block to allocate the buffer from the pool. There are typically 5 scenarios the kernel may follow in gate block to allocate a buffer for a disk blocks. Now scenario 4 and 5. Now here the fourth scenario is block could not be found on the hash queue and the free list of buffer is empty. And fifth scenario is block was found on the hash queue but its buffer is currently busy. Now we have already explained this diagram in our previous videos. Here we'll have the hash queue headers. In the hash queue headers we'll have the total 4 blocks, block number 0, 1, 2 and 3. Now on the right hand side we'll have the buffers. In these buffers we'll have the data blocks like 28, 4, 64, 17, 5, 97, 98, 50, 10, 3, 35 and 99. So now this is nothing but the buffers on the hash queue. Here to implement this particular hash queue we are going to use the hash function. That hash function is nothing but the block number mod n. N is nothing but the size of our hash queue headers. Now let's look at the scenario 4. Block could not be found on the hash queue and the free list of buffer is empty. Means when a particular buffer, a particular process is searching for any block, that block is not found on the hash queue. Then the expected thing is what? We need to allocate the buffer from the free list. But in the scenario 4, that particular block is not available in the hash queue and to perform or to continue its task we need to allocate that buffer from the free list, but that free list is again empty. If you look into the free list header at the bottom of this hash queue, here in this diagram, in these links, we do not have any free buffer. So now here in this scenario we are searching for the block 18. Now if you look into the block 18, like to search for the particular that block 18, we need to execute that hashing function again. Means what? 18 mod 4 will get the 2 as a reminder. Means we are going to search that 18 into the block number 2. But now in the block number 2 we'll have the 98, 50, 10, but we do not have the 18. So now here is expected is we need to allocate the buffer from the empty list, free list, but here we do not have any free list. Now this is the scenario 4. Now here what we need to do here, now process A and process B searching for the block B on the hash queue, but it's not available on the hash queue and free buffer is not available on the free list. Now in this situation both the process are enters into the sleep state. Now if you look into this diagram here, that is nothing but the race for the free buffer. Here process A cannot find the block B on the hash queue, no buffers on the free list, then it will goes into the sleep state. Now when process 1 is in the sleep state, now process B is entering into the searching, requesting for that buffer or block. Now here cannot find the block B on the hash queue, no buffers on the free list, then again that process B again enters into the sleep state. Means here both the process A and B are enters into the sleeping state. Now somebody free a buffer, it means now here some other process releases the buffers, then here we need to allocate that buffer to the this sleeping process. Now here we need to wake up the buffer. Now here take a buffer from the free list and assign to the block B. Means here when the buffer is released, that buffer is attached to the free list header, and then now we'll assign that buffer to the block B, and then after assigning that block B, process A or B will request for the block B. So now in this way, in scenario 4, the process enters into the sleeping states. Now scenario 5, this is the last scenario of this get block algorithms. Now here block was found on the hash queue, but its buffer is currently busy. Means what? Now here we are currently searching for some block on the hash queue. That block is present, but that block is already assigned to some process. Means some process is performing some operations with the help of that block. So now we'll mark that block as busy. If we look into the diagram here, searching for the block 99, and that block is busy. Right? Now this is the scenario. Now here, what we'll do? Again, the same thing here we need to do. We need to perform like some process is searching for the 99. We need to execute that block using the hashing function. Means 99 mod 4 will get the 3 as a reminder. Now here we'll search for that block into that particular block numbers. Now here we'll get the 3, 35, and then next one is 99. Here we got the block 99, but that block is already marked as a busy, and we knew that already. That busy means what? Busy means that particular block is currently available on the hash queue, but that has been already assigned by some other process. Now here we need to again wait. Here we'll see actually what going to happen. The kernel guarantees that all process waiting for the buffers will wake up, because it allocates buffer during the execution of the system calls and free them before the returning. Now here this diagram will represent the race for blocked buffer. Now here process A, process B and process C will have the 3 process. Now here process A allocate buffer to block B, and then we'll lock that buffer. And now here process A will initiate some IO operations. Now here sleep until IO operation done. Means what? Here that process A has been already blocked or locked that particular block B, and here it is waiting for the IO operations. Now till it will get the IO operations, it will goes into the sleep. Now at that time here process B will come into the picture, and it is searching for or finding for the block B on the hash queue, but that buffer is locked. Then again process B is goes into the sleep state. Now C came into the picture. Now sleep waiting for any free buffers. That is nothing but the scenario 4 actually. And now in this timeline, what happened? When process A will done with the IO operation, then it will wake up. It will perform its operations and it will release the buffer. So now here BR release, buffer release is nothing but the function. It will release the buffer and it will wake up the others. Means process A, after completion of its tasks, it will wake up the process B and C. Now here process C get the buffer previously assigned to the block B and reassign buffer to block B. Then in process B, buffer does not contain block B, then start searching again. Now this one is nothing but the scenario 5. Now here we'll see the algorithm, how scenario 4 and 5 will work. Now here we'll have the while buffer not found. If block is in the hash queue, then what we'll do? If buffer is busy, then go to the sleep. event buffer from the becomes the sorry buffer becomes the free till it is get the slip, then it will continue. Else if buffer are no sorry if there are no buffers on the free list, then again it will goes into the slip. That is nothing but the scenario 4, and then it will continue. Means in both the scenario 4 and 5, the process will goes into the slip state. Now think and write the answer for this. Just give the name, name to this condition particularly. What if buffer is busy and many process requesting for the same buffer? Now this is the situation. Now what we can say, what we can call to this situation? Now here is the answer. We can call it as a race condition. Means multiple processes trying to access that particular buffer. Then all these buffers are goes into the race condition. They are racing for the particular buffer. Means all process must go into the waiting state. References: Design of Unix Operating System by Maurice J. Batch. Thank you very much.